Welcome everyone, this is Joy of Joy Morris Beauty, and in this video I'm gonna be discussing 5 ordinary skincare products worth trying, so stay tuned. Okay, so I got notes because I have a lot I want to say, so bear with me. So my kind of introductory statement to this skincare video that I've been holding on to for a while. So I kind of have a mission right now, which I talked about on my last lock video, where I'm kind of focused on, you know, natural beauty and, you know, wearing less makeup is just kind of my preference right now. And then I'm getting older a little bit too. You know, I just turned 39, and what's funny is there's some articles out that I heard about from another makeup artist who, you know, was kind of discussing this, where they say that once you hit about 39 is when you start kind of being self-conscious that you're getting older and things like that, and that you need some intervention. So I would say I definitely fit in that category, because I, like clockwork, I just turned 39 and now I'm like, what's going on, how are we looking here? So I have actually been working on building a skincare routine for the past several months, and I'm going to insert a video here of what my skin looked like several months ago. I've been slowly working in some products here and there because I didn't want to overwhelm myself. I've always been the type of person who thought really complicated skincare routines were silly. And then I've always had, you know, reasonably good skin, so I always kept it simple. And I've always gotten a lot of compliments on my skin too, which made me just feel less pressure to kind of, you know, work on it per se. But my opinions and my thoughts about it have really, really kind of evolved this year. And so now we're here. So several months ago, you know, I was kind of looking at my skin. I was deciding I wanted to start wearing my contacts more. You know, I've worn glasses since I was 5. And as you can see, I have these really, really dark marks that I've been working on, and just some other things with my skin I want to fix. I got some hyperpigmentation and I got some little bit of acne, and you know, I got some things here and there I want to work on, and I have been working on them. So I'm about 2 months into my new skincare routine, which I've been using some ordinary products. And then I am in the process right now of continuing to kind of work them in. So I'm kind of bringing you into that whole process with me. So the first product that I'm going to discuss is, and I know so many people know about this one, is the Buffett, which is, I think, one of those serums that probably people tend to gravitate towards first when they use ordinary products. And I'm sure so many people have used it at this point, but you know, it's just kind of like a clear, almost milky white serum that just kind of really helps to improve the look of your skin overall. And I actually used it some years ago, and then I was like, whatever, I'm gonna do something else. I ain't gonna be doing all them serums and whatever. And then here I'm coming back to the serums. So this was one of the first products that I gravitated towards. And I feel like the Buffett has really been helping my skin to kind of plump up almost. And it just kind of overall really helps, you know, your complexion look better. So I've been really happy and pleased to use this. But as I continue to grow in my ordinary routine and kind of delving into the brand, I think I want to branch out and try some other things. But if you are new to the ordinary and new to kind of building a routine, I think that the Buffett serum for overall improvement in your skin is a great place to start. This one was new for me. This is the Glycolic Acid 7% Toning Solution. And I have not really been in the past a person who would use, like, you know, acids and things like that on my skin, or like exfoliating toners. I have other types of exfoliants that I use, but I was never really into that. So it had really, really good reviews. I said, let me go ahead and try this. So I tried it and it did tingle a little bit, but I feel like it's really been helping over the past couple months for my skin to have a real kind of like subtle glow to it. And by using the word glow, I feel like it's been gradually helping my skin just kind of look, you know, a bit more even, because that's been kind of like a big issue that I've had with my skin tone just being really, really uneven. So I'm gonna keep using it. But something that I noticed recently And then this kind of segues into another topic that I wanted to introduce, is I found out that these two products can basically kind of interact with each other, and that you shouldn't necessarily use them together. And the way I found that out was, I had a dream. Actually, this actually all happened like last night. So I had a dream, you know, as I was kind of like planning through all this, and I was like, what if there's like a skincare app that I could use that would help me kind of figure all this out, as I'm really kind of wanting to build this routine. So I did a quick search on my iPhone, and I found this cap. I think it's literally called like the skincare app. And it's built off of the ordinary products, but you can add other products in. And then you, as you add the products in that you're using, it puts them in different slots, like according to their purpose. So like, you know, this is like the PM, you know, acne treatment, and this is your AM serum, and this is your PM oil, and different things like that. So I downloaded it. It's about $4. So I downloaded it. And as soon as I started plugging stuff in, it told me that there was an interaction between these two. And the interaction was that they said, you're not supposed to use a peptide with a direct acid. So as you check off the products that you use, it tells you which other ones that you have like available, you know, in your stash that you should not use that day. So I've been using these like back to back for like 2 months. Oops. And sure enough, over the past couple weeks, my cheeks have gotten really sensitive to the point where that was another reason why I took a break. I mean, a complete break from wearing makeup, like foundation or concealer or anything, or even primer, because it started like stinging in my cheek area, which is something I've never ever experienced before. So that was just a mistake that I made, and I figured out it's probably because these two aren't supposed to be used back to back. But you know, you learn and you grow. So that's one reason why, as I build my routine, I'm going to continue to use this app, and I wanted to make sure to mention it in case any of you all out there might need a bit of assistance like that, because I'm not an esthetician. I'm not a dermatologist. I don't claim to have some vast database of all these different skincare products and how they react in my mind. I don't claim that at all. Here's another new addition, literally yesterday. And so, like I said, this video is in real time with what's like really, really going on with me and my kind of skincare situation. So this is the organic cold press rosehip seed oil. And so I had been using a nighttime oil from another brand for maybe 2 years. And so I'm not gonna say the other one didn't work. Maybe my skin got used to it, I don't know. But I put this on last night, and when I woke up in the morning, I was like, is this my face? Is this my face? Like, I felt like my face already was more even. I felt like my skin was brighter. It was softer. When I touched my skin, I felt like my pores weren't as pronounced as they usually are. I was just really blown away. I said, all this from an oil? Like, seriously? So this oil is gonna be my friend. The next product is the Ascorbyl. This is where you're like, what did you say? Trying my best to pronounce these. This is the Ascorbyl Glucoside Solution 12%, fancy word for vitamin C derivative serum. So this is a brightening serum, which I said, I feel like I need that. I'm trying to get the right combination together to do what I need it to do. So I just used this morning for the first time. I cannot report on it yet, but based off of me kind of scanning through the other vitamin C serums and products that they had, this was the one that I thought I would really like. So far, so good. And then this is the fifth one I wanted to discuss. See, I haven't even opened a box yet. This is, again, be like, what did she say? This is Alpha Arbutin 2% plus HA, which I'm not sure exactly what the HA stands for. I'm not sure if that's, it is. Yeah, hyaluronic acid. So it is. And the reason I purchased this to add this in is because this specializes in helping with hyperpigmentation and dark spots. So I'm really hoping, and I'm going to start using this tonight, you know, being accountable with you guys. So, you know, I'm being honest here with, you know, what I have going on. I'm going to work this in tonight, and I'm going to be focused on you know, my marks for my glasses, which actually have started to improve over the past several months. Just for me not wearing my glasses, I only wear them like a little bit in the morning, a little bit at night, but most of the day I have on my contacts. And then starting my skincare routine, I looked really closely at two pictures side to side and I saw that my skin is kind of improving. So that's, excuse me, that's a good thing. But I want them gone. I want them gone as they can be. So, you know, we're gonna kick it up a notch and see how that works. So I'd love to hear from you all. Anybody out there using ordinary products, or, you know, you have a routine down? Do you have an app that you use or anything that's been helping you? Do you have any questions? If I can't answer the questions, maybe I can help you figure out how to answer the questions. So go ahead and leave a comment below and we'll chat in the comment section. Make sure to subscribe to follow my skincare journey and take care. Bye-bye.